It's Fran again at my bench, and I just got this contact tachometer in. I have a need for a contact tachometer for measuring the speeds of motors and such like that. I'm going to be doing some more mechanical projects, and it was just I wanted to have one around. I actually had a really good one years ago that I got in a secondhand shop for peanuts, but it was one of the many items that I had to purge 5 moves ago when I downsized tremendously. It was just amongst piles of gear that I didn't think I would ever need, and then of course times change. But so I bought this. I didn't pay a lot for it, which was good, because I just right out of the box there were problems with this. Now people are gonna say, well, you didn't pay a lot for this, what do you expect? True. But you know what I expect is a usable instrument, and in a contact tachometer, as far as I could imagine, there's really only 2 critical components. There's a bearing, right, which has to be smooth and sturdy for the shaft, and there has to be a decent opto encoder to read the motion of the shaft accurately, and the rest is just all processing. So, you know, as far as I'm concerned, this is really just two things. I mean, it comes with the tips, and you got a wheel, so you can, you know, with a little rubberized insert, you can put this around a belt, you know, if you're got a mechanism with a belt drive, or you can put it right up against another wheel, you know. You got the various points. Here's the little adapter for the points, and that goes on the shaft here. Right, that's a good fit. Right, but on the end here, you got these rubber inserts, and they don't even fit. I mean, you can see it's just there's no tension. I can just drop it right out. You know, they're both like that. This larger one is just there. And so I had to, in order to get this even to like hold in there to use, because you know this is gonna be, you know, putting up against something that's spinning at high speed. If I just do it like this, and I'm gonna use the table here to simulate a surface, I just put it up against it, and it's just, you know, hello. And not only that, but I also noticed that, let's take a look at the shaft here. Just putting it up against the surface and running, again, I said there's only 2 parts to a contact tachometer. One is the bearing. Well, this, I can feel metal sliding against metal. I don't even think there's a bearing in there. In fact, I put oil in there. I put a drop of oil in just to make it smoother. But it doesn't even like feel like there's a bearing in there. It just looks like there's like a piece of metal rolling around in another piece of metal. It's loose. I don't feel ball bearings. You know, you don't feel that sort of slidey feel. It just seems like a piece of metal kind of loosely pushed into another piece of metal. So anyway, this is just, you know, too cheap. I mean, I didn't pay nothing for it, but I do want to take this open and just take a look at what I bought. Well, for a cheap device, they sure didn't skimp on screws. This thing's loaded with them. But yeah, that really good tachometer I had, it was an older one, but, you know, I did some research. I found out that those high-resolution, like, rugged professional contact tachometers can run a few $100s for a decent one, so it's like, it was one of those things, it's like, why did you get rid of it? Well, you know, there were lots of things that I've said, why did I get rid of that? But it always comes down to, I just didn't have the room. Alright, so. Alright, well, very very sort of DIY kind of circuit board with the black masking on it, you know, kind of like an Arduino board. Whoa! This just fell off. Okay, so that was just sitting in there. And it just... Alright, so right away, what did I say? It just feels like a piece of metal without a bearing in it. And I said there's only two things that this thing really needs to be. A good bearing and a good optical encoder. Now this is clearly not a good optical encoder because it's just a piece of plastic with some wide gaps in it. I wouldn't call that high resolution. And it's just going between this infrared LED and this receiver, and they're not even like aiming at each other. So yeah, we're talking about quality with a capital K. I mean, how hard can it be, you know, to make this decent? You know, I think that's glued in. Oh, because yeah, the display, yeah, so it's just it's got one of those contact strips on the other side, and there's a piece of rubber here, so it feels like they've just glued it in place. So yeah. Wow, okay, well, I don't think there's any hope for this to be like a, you know, I'm gonna take this apart to see if there is a bearing. I don't think there is. It doesn't look like it's a bearing. It just looks like a, like I thought, you know, two pieces of metal pressed together. Well, it doesn't really reveal anything. Well, definitely the oil I put in there has gotten in. I mean, since I put oil on it, it's definitely more goozy, but it's just so loose. It's definitely not a ball bearing. It's not enough size in there for to be a ball bearing, but there's not even any, I can't see any like sintered brass or anything like that. It's just really, it's just, looks like it's just two steel surfaces sort of just in close contact with one another. And it's loose. It's very loose. But yeah, okay, that's definitely built down to a cost. Obviously, I'm very tempted to just sort of buy a decent one, but I just really don't want to spend that kind of dough for something that I really wasn't planning on using that often. It's tough with test equipment. If you don't really have a need for something too frequently, it's hard to invest. So I'm gonna just see if I can get these reasonably pointing at each other. Is the encoder going round and round? You know what? I see that. Do you see the other problem here? It's not even centered. So I guess the reason they had those aimed up is they're not even like through the center line. So they're sort of. So I guess one side, the LED is just sort of just bathing that in infrared light, and this one is just sort of trying to peep it whenever an opening comes by. That's just and look at, I mean, that's got to affect that wobble. That's got to affect the accuracy, wouldn't you think? This is a piece of junk. Nuvoton. It's a Nuvoton. Yeah, it's a 7400 chip there. Nothing exciting. I guess the answer to the question, can a cheap contact tachometer be any good? The answer is no. It is not. At least not anything like this. Very disappointed. Like I said, there's only like two things that would make a contact tachometer work. That's the bearing and the encoder, and this gets failing marks on both. So everything else, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter how good the electronics is, because if the with the bearing and encoder, I can't trust that this is going to be accurate in anything over a walking pace. I mean, sure, at very slow speeds, I'm sure this is going to be reasonably accurate as anything, but if we get up into thousands of RPM, no, I wouldn't think that this would be. And not only that, but in order to get these, unless I glue one of these in place, which I probably will do, because I found that when I shim it with a piece of paper, kind of crap style, it creates a problem where it'll go in tight, but now it's off center. So, you know, and it kind of has a wobble to it. So I'll probably have to just put like a ring of cyanoacrylate glue in there and just kind of like set it in. Perfect. Brand new. Ultra liquid control. That sounds like what we need. Always wear gloves when I work with super glue, because it's much better than having to deal with fingers that are bonded together. Screw it in to break the seal. There we go. And then you unscrew it. Pretty slick. Okay. Oh! It says ultimate liquid control. See, I ended up splattering that instead of getting it on my skin. Just getting it on my gloves. So there you go. Alright, let that set. Alright, I'm just going to let that dry and use that later. But yeah, so, well, I guess I'm just going to have to make do with what I got, which is, you know, a piece of junk. But it answers the question, can you get a good, cheap contact tachometer? The answer is no. It's a piece of junk. All right. Well, live and learn. That's it. I'm Fran. I'll be back here at the bench with something that's not a piece of crap real soon. Thanks to all the patrons down there on Patreon making all these videos possible, including this video about a junk tachometer. But thank you, thank you, thank you, everyone on Patreon. All right. I'm back real soon. At the bench again.